It's very difficult to have a concept of this for a very good reason. It's not because we're stupid. It's because these processes have been disguised. They operate in stealth. They have been engineered to be indecipherable, to be undetectable, to create ignorance in a vast group of all of us that they call users. Our ignorance is their bliss. There are some things that have broken through into the public view that we do know about. So let's talk about Facebook's massive scale contagion experiments. And this is where Facebook experimented with subliminal cues planted in its Facebook pages that would actually influence offline, real world behavior and emotions to see if they could make people feel happier or sadder using subliminal cues with language manipulation and word manipulation and so on. Well, when the experimenters wrote up this work in the very prestigious scholarly journals that published the results of these experiments, they emphasized two key findings. Number one, we now know that we can manipulate subliminal cues in the online context to change real-world behavior or real-world emotion. We know that we can be successful at doing this. Number two, we can exercise this power, these methods, while bypassing user awareness.
Een grote groep Pokémon Go-spelers heeft met elkaar afgesproken in Leeuwarden. Samen gaan ze de stad door om zoveel mogelijk Pokémon te vangen. Alleen in Nederland al spelen ruim 1,3 miljoen mensen het spel.
A very interesting experiment occurs in the guise of an augmented reality game called Pokémon Go.
In het spel loop je rond in de echte wereld. Op allerlei plekken zitten Pokémon verstopt. Je moet er dus naartoe gaan om ze te verzamelen.
What are we not seeing when Pokémon Go is introduced in our country?
It's important to understand that Pokémon Go is an augmented reality game that was incubated, developed inside Google for many years. Google being the first pioneer of surveillance capitalism, the inventor of surveillance capitalism. Pokémon Go was invented in Google, incubated there for many years, developed there. Led by a man named John Hankey. And John Hankey invented an operation called Keyhole, which was invested in by the CIA and later purchased by Google and called Google Earth.
Google Earth was a CIA startup initially?
Yes, Google Earth was something called Keyhole, and it was a CIA-invested startup. So it's important to understand that Pokémon Go was not some happy little game that just got launched into the world by a toy company or something. When they decided to bring Pokémon Go to the public, they didn't want to bring it as a Google game. They brought it to market as Niantic Labs, which no one had ever heard of. Just a cool startup with this cool game. So now we have this Google augmented reality game, and it turns out that the big game that is on top of the little game that the children are playing is a game that precisely emulates the logic of surveillance capitalism. So in surveillance capitalism, in the original version online, we predict the click-through rate, and we sell the click-through rate to the advertiser who pays to get clicks on their website, clicking through ultimately to the buy button. That's what they're hoping for. Now, in the real world, business customers paid Niantic Labs, Pokemon Go company, paid Niantic Labs, not for click-through, but for the real-world equivalent of click-through, which is called footfall. To actually get real bodies with their real feet into real business establishments so that their feet would go fall, 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 tap, tap, tap across the store or across the restaurant or across the bar in order to buy something.
So I could order by Niantic Labs a Pokemon in my ice cream parlor, for instance.
All of these establishments, they're buying what are called, here's the term, lure modules. Modules like a gym that lure people to you. Not so that they will come and be happy, but so they will come and spend money in your shop or your restaurant. Starbucks, McDonald's, everybody was making money. Everybody was making money. Niantic Labs was making money, and all these businesses were making money. And the people playing the game had no idea. So they used the rewards and punishment of the game to herd you through the city to the places that were paying for your body. This was the game of Pokemon Go. This was the real game, the shadow game, getting you into a place where we have predicted that you will be, so that our predictions are worth more. If I can guarantee you're actually going to be there, my prediction that you're going to be there is worth a lot more. Economies of action are how I guarantee that. And Pokemon Go was a large-scale experiment, a global-scale experiment in economies of action, using remote control means to automate behavior, to engineer behavior, to fulfill others' commercial ends while you are having a great time. You are intended to be in the feeling of being served. You are intended to be saturated with convenience so that you will not notice and you will not complain. And all of this shadow operation will remain hidden because you will not ask questions, because you're so busy being entertained.